INFJs are known for their imaginative minds and their drive for learning and improving themselves while gaining new experiences along the way. One of the more exciting ways this personality type is able to achieve these new experiences is through their wanderlust. That is, only for the INFJs that have the courage to take the leap. Welcome, or welcome back, Psychos. Today, we're going to be talking about the INFJ Traveller. But before we get into it, have you liked and subscribed to our channel? Go ahead, we'll wait for you. And don't forget to ring the notification bell while you're at it so you never miss a video. Number 1. They need alone time. INFJs don't go and travel like most other personality types do. In fact, they have their personal set of needs and rituals that carry over even when they're exploring the other side of the world. One of these needs is their classic introverted need for alone time. Surprise, surprise, right? An INFJ might be labelled an extroverted introvert and may very well show this side of them when socialising with travelling strangers they meet along the way. But they also desperately need to make time for solitude, especially for longer trips. This can definitely come off as a bit of a shock for people travelling with them or to the people they meet along the way. So it's helpful for INFJs to communicate this necessity beforehand if possible. And if their alone time is not taken seriously, they can surely reach their brink of burnout, which will ultimately make the trip suck for everyone involved. Not only does a little recharge time allow for the INFJ to be in a better mood, but it will also help them better internalize their experiences during the trip. Number 2. They look for conversation. As most of us know, deep conversations are fundamental for the INFJ personality type, since they crave meaning in all their life experiences, lessons, and relationships. Talking and sharing while traveling is one of the most essential information travels for their quest of meaning. INFJs may even find themselves a little more tolerant to things like small talk when exploring different cultures of the world, as it provides them insight into properly analysing new people. Yet, of course, INFJs will always be more interested when it comes to engaging in interesting and meaningful information exchanges with new people, particularly locals. This allows them to know how local customs translate similarly in other countries like their own or in other places they've traveled to before. INFJs are always looking to find common ground and inspiration wherever they go. And the best way to bridge differences between an INFJ and another person is through a deep conversation. Number 3. Document, document, document. With introverted intuition as their most dominant function, INFJs tend to mentally analyze their experiences after they've happened in order to really appreciate all angles of it. When INFJs are in the moment, they're too busy subconsciously analyzing and collecting data to fully embrace their surroundings, especially when it comes to traveling where everything they're absorbing is new. In fact, when traveling, the INFJ has several experiences through their mind and body. They meet new people, they interact with unknown territory, they're understanding a new culture and its intricacies while also tasting their food and learning their customs. With so many things happening at once, documenting their experiences for an awesome way for INFJs to not only relive and reflect on these times in the comfort of their own imaginations, but also to look back on in the years to come. Using a travel journal, a personal blog, or even documenting their experience through photographs can help the INFJ live their traveling experience to the fullest. And who knows, your findings could even be the starting point of a memoir if done right. Number 4. They plan ahead. INFJs are planners, and if there's one thing that all INFJs prefer to do in hopes of garnering their sense of security is planning ahead for their trips. As a matter of fact, if someone is able to happily pack and prepare for a last-minute trip, you can bet they are not an INFJ personality type. Being a judging personality type in particular means that INFJs prefer to know in advance where they're sleeping, where they're eating, and what places they are visiting in order to fully embrace the moment when it comes. Without the planning aspect of travel, INFJs can easily feel too out of order and panicked, especially in new surroundings. While it's not uncommon for INFJs to rely on a series of checklists to double-check they're optimally prepared, their common sense usually prompts them to prepare for things that nobody has anticipated. Plus, going to a new city without an exact plan of what they're doing seems counterintuitive when you're looking to maximize your time spent somewhere. Number 5. INFJs adapt to any situation. While INFJs are known for their planning, you can't plan for everything, and luckily, have a good balance of adaptability when it comes time. Sure, last-minute changes aren't exactly their cup of tea, but when it comes to adapting to new ways of life, new foods, new people, and new environments, INFJs can fit in just fine. Using their chameleon-like abilities, INFJs can easily pick up on cultural manners, body language, gestures, and even accents or slang to make it easier to communicate and fit into their environment. They're naturally attuned to social norms and expectations, and are also able to read other people easily. Of course, this can also be a double-edged sword, considering that constantly assessing and reassessing the room's vibe and people's attitudes can be quite tiring, but it's all part of their deep information processing. Number 6. They avoid tourist traps. The INFJ travels looking not only for new experiences, but genuine culture and country offerings that you can get in other areas of the world. This means that instead of following the must-see tourist traps that seek to provide tourists with insincere facts and interest in a country's culture, they opt for the local experience. The perfect example of this independent personality type preferring the unbeaten path in life, the INFJ goes out of their way to find hidden gems, local restaurants, community hobbies, and other genuine experiences wherever they go. Another example of this would be their preference to stay at an Airbnb or hostel in comparison to a hotel, all just for the experience. Number 7. They travel wholeheartedly. It probably doesn't come as a surprise, considering most things the INFJ's all-or-nothing approach to most things in life. However, when it comes to traveling, this passionate personality type takes this all-or-nothing approach quite seriously. In fact, you can say the INFJ is actually goal-focused in their travels, as they are the most self-improving experiences of their lives. If they set out to go to the Bahamas, you can be sure they're probably not going to stay on a beach resort, but instead to clean the beaches with a group of like-minded volunteers. Or if they have a long travel commute, you can be sure they'll opt for the scenic route, even if it takes a little more time. In other words, when the INFJ is somewhere to experience something, they'll put their all into it, and that doesn't change with the INFJ traveler. Number 8. They're thrifty. Frugal and thrifty, the INFJ traveler favors bargains far and wide, so they'll always be looking around for coupons, discounts, and venue passes that can maximize their travel budget. Remember that INFJs are all for planning ahead and maximizing their time, and this also translates to their travel expenses. They may even opt for travel work exchanges for free accommodation or volunteer positions for free goods. To the INFJ, bargaining always seems to leave them with new experiences that wouldn't have happened if they took the easy way out. Not to mention, when the INFJ has the opportunity to help in exchange for compensation that doesn't involve money, it's always a win-win in their eyes. Number 9. Long roads and sightseeing. If there's one thing the INFJ loves to do most while traveling, it's watching the world go by. Natural observers, most INFJs love the concept of sightseeing, scenic drives, people watching, and nature bathing in other parts of the world. While they opt for the local experiences, sometimes travel musts, like a tour on the double-decker or a short sightseeing tour of famous buildings, can be all the INFJ needs to immerse themselves in new experiences without the stress of having to plan it all out. But aside from tours and guides, the INFJ loves the simple things. They want to experience the sunset in Hawaii, the mountains in the Himalayas, the exotic animals in Australia, and they want to witness and absorb the little things that money just can't buy. And number 10, they need a vacation at the end. With all the things they most likely invested their energy on doing when traveling, there's a high chance that the INFJ will need what's known as a vacation. They need to rest from investing so much energy trying to do it all. while analysing and observing every little detail along the way. Even if the INFJ opts for solo travel, they still require a good amount of alone time once they come back in order to regroup themselves and reprocess the things they've learned during their travels. And with this break time, sometimes comes feelings of sadness or frustration that the trip came and went so fast. But unfortunately, that happens for most people. And now, back to reality. So, that's all for today, Psychos. Make sure to comment down below if you've felt any of these needs while travelling as an INFJ. Also, don't forget to leave us a like, share this video with your friends, and also subscribe to our channel for more Psycho videos.